For years now, China has been trying to assert and expand its influence in the Indian Ocean. Recently, in the aftermath of United States House Speaker Nancy Pelosi's visit to Taiwan, Beijing docked its ship at Hambantota port. Although the two sides described it as a part of a peaceful patrolling process, the observers have rubbished the statement, saying China had clearly used a military ship to intercept and snoop on other countries' facilities in the country, especially that of India. A report.
As the U.S.-China battle for supremacy escalated in the past few weeks following Nancy Pelosi's visit to Taiwan, China's continued attempts to assert its influence in the Indian Ocean remain unabated. Beijing docked what military experts call a dual-use spy ship, Yuan Wang 5, at Sri Lanka's Hambantota port in the Indian Ocean. The ship was docked at the port from August 16th to August 22nd. The bigger question, however, is why. While some say it was Beijing's response to Washington's recent diplomatic maneuvers in the South China Sea, others call it an attempt to prevent deepening India-Sri Lanka ties, especially in the wake of India's continued multifaceted support to the island nation during its economic and political crisis. While New Delhi raised concerns over the ship's docking, Sri Lanka, which according to the observers finds itself caught between a rock and a hard place, released a statement in consonance with the Chinese stance. The statement said that there were no underpinnings to the recent developments at the port, and the docking of Yuan Wang 5 was merely a part of the regular patrolling exercises. Experts skeptical of both China and Sri Lanka's explanations have asked why an ultra-modern space-tracking ship used to monitor satellite, rocket, and intercontinental ballistic missile launches was used for a patrolling exercise.
It's very clearly a spy ship. Sri Lanka knows exactly what it is. Sri Lanka also knows the consequences of what is going to happen. India also knows that if you allow it to happen once, it's going to happen over and over again, and then it might even become a permanent base after that.
Clearly, there is more to the situation than what meets the eye. As per media reports, Sri Lanka was initially reluctant to allow the ship to enter its waters, fearing this could impact the island nation's chances of securing monetary support from neighbor India, the other Quad member Japan, and other Western countries. However, experts believe that Beijing leveraged its dominance in the Beijing-Colombo bilateral arrangement, and Sri Lanka caved to Chinese pressure. Sri Lanka succumbing to China's debt-trap diplomacy could also be another factor. China remains a large creditor to Sri Lanka, and the cash-strapped island nation has been instructed by the IMF to begin debt restructuring talks with China in order to secure a bailout for its people, who are suffering from crippling shortages of basic necessities. Currently, Sri Lanka is negotiating for a package between 2 to 3 billion USD, and without Beijing's nod, the process might plunge into an indefinite delay. Although Sri Lanka is not in any position to put up any form of resistance to China, its tourism minister, Harun Fernando, who was in India last week, said India has turned out to be a close friend of Sri Lanka, and that India was being kept apprised of the real-time situation in Sri Lanka through top channels. Unlike China, India's support to Sri Lanka continues to flow without any strings attached.
Sri Lanka has to be good friends with everyone. And I'm sure India understands it. And we have had a very good diplomatic relationship with India. And our foreign minister, our president, is constant touch with the foreign minister here and the Prime Minister Modi as well.
The recent turn of events has also rung loud alarm bells for the West. Beijing's control over the Hambantota port also means that Beijing, if remaining unchallenged, can gain control and thereby disrupt the Asia-Europe trade route. An already crippled supply chain will go for a toss if any confrontation occurs in the region. Experts say it is also a challenge for the Quad, the security alliance between the US, India, Australia, and Japan. While they have been pushing for a free Indo-Pacific, Beijing continues to flex its muscles in the region with frequent naval superiority exercises and show of force by military jets. Experts also say that the main area of focus should still be on the reality on the ground in Sri Lanka. The island nation and its people are still deep in the throes of economic and political crisis, and the priority should be on first helping the Sri Lankan people.